Many of you will remember Carol from a previous video where we looked at some spots on her hand and we froze off the little barnacles there. Today we're looking at a spot on her back. You showed this to me. Do you know how long it's been there?
No.
Okay, we don't know how long this has been there. I don't like the look of it. Mm-hmm. In a previous video, we went over the ABCDEs of skin cancer about asymmetry, border irregularity, color variation, diameter greater than 6 millimeter, evolving color or shape. And this thing has, well, we can't say evolving shape or color because we don't know what it looked like before, but it has all of the other things that are concerning for a skin cancer. So we're going to get a punch biopsy where we go all the way through all the layers of the skin. So if there's something growing deep down, we'll get it and get that evaluated and make sure it's not the bad type of skin cancer called malignant melanoma. That's the thing we most want to make sure. Yeah, we want to make sure that's not there. Mm-hmm. We're hoping it's a seborrheic keratosis. That's a benign, kind of a mole type structure.
What kind did I have on my nose? That was
That was either a basal cell or a squamous cell.
It was basal cell.
Basal cell. And those, they just grow locally. You just get rid of them locally. They don't spread anywhere else.
We got rid of it finally.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Carol, you're going to feel this. I apologize. It does sting as it goes in. We're getting it numbed deep down and all around so that wherever we take the sample will be good. We do have to choose where to get the sample when we're doing a punch biopsy, because I'm not going to take the whole thing out with that size of punch. We're going to get this area here where you see the most variation in the color. It's kind of central. Some lesions you want to get the leading edge of it, so that'd be like out here, but that's more for rashes, not so much for when you're concerned about cancerous growth. So right in that area there, you see a little bit of light color. Light colored areas can be very concerning in malignant melanoma, or can be a clue that's malignant melanoma, because sometimes the cancer will produce dark color. And where it outruns its blood supply, you'll get this involution. It'll actually be light colored in part of it. So we really want to get a sample of this to make sure. And here we go. Want to include the light colored portion. Look at that, it just popped out. It wants out. We don't want that to go any further. And we'll stop the bleeding by closing the wound. That's how you stop bleeding. You're doing okay, Carol?
Oh, yeah. No pain.
Good, good, good. So there, we'll probably put a bandage over it because there is that tiny little bit of drainage still. So we'll get that on shortly. And then we'll get the results probably before the weekend.
Okay, but you're gonna just have to burn these off, right?
Yeah. Yes, and we'll get the sutures taken out in about 10 days, 14 days, something like that.
Well, that was easy.
Wow.
Hey, thanks for watching as Carol got that taken off. We're gonna get the results, and Carol, do we have your permission to put the results in the description of the video?
Of course.
So people can know. Please do in the comments, tell Carol that you're praying for her and care about her recovery from this. We're hoping that it will be just a benign growth. We don't know until we get it checked. If those of you who aren't already subscribers, please subscribe to the channel. And if you would like to see behind the scenes material like BooBoo Kitty and Lindsay Antwine and Petra Rosenberg, please become a patron. Until next time, Carol and myself telling you to stay in good health.